Hey friends, welcome back. It's Danielle. Marianne over at Shopping Crafty tagged me in this video, and it's been forever since I've done a tag or a collab, so I was really excited for this. And we've got 7 questions here, and I'm really excited to answer these and see what you guys have for answers. So if you would like to leave your answers in the description box, or I mean in the comment box, please do so if you don't do YouTube videos. Now, if you have done a video on this, let me know in a comment also, and I will link your video in the description box. So any videos that I can find of people who have done this tag already, I will leave in the description box. Of course, Marianne at Shopping Crafty will be up at the very top, so you guys can check out her channel. She has great content. Okay, number one, what are the most important frugal things you do every day to save money? Number one for us, that is sort of always on our mind, is our air conditioning since it's summer, but also heat in the winter. So for us, controlling that thermostat, making sure we put it on a higher temperature or a lower temperature if it's winter, when we leave the house, is just something we've got to be conscious of every single day. It can save more than a few pennies to really control that thermostat. Second thing is to ask ourselves what is most important. Now, I definitely got some tough love and some great advice in the comment section when I was asking for help on how to control our spending with eating out. So one of them was just really think about every single day when you wake up or when you're getting ready for work, what is the most important thing today? And is that going out to eat later for dinner, or is that cooking right now so that you can have something for dinner and not have to go out? And so it's asking that and reminding yourself every single day, hey, there's a goal and this is how you get there. And think about that goal. You know, we think about our goal every day, but we don't always think, hey, what are the steps I need to do today to make this goal happen? And that's, you know, changing the thermostat. That's asking ourselves what's most important. And I think that change of mindset from thinking about our goal and wanting to get there to thinking about the actionable steps that will get us there. So the actionable steps are really what I want to try to focus on a little bit more. And so far this month, it's working. Also, watching YouTube or Dave Ramsey videos. So there's tons and tons of people in this frugal community, in the debt-free community. I just joined Instagram, and hashtag debt-free community is a big one that I had no idea was out there. I'm loving it. If you have a cool Instagram, let me know your username and I'll go subscribe to you. Okay. Number two, what is your best strategy for saving on utilities? So I'll start with electricity. Going back to number one, it's controlling that thermostat. Also, of course, if it's cold, adding more clothes. If it's hot, wearing shorts and not wearing socks around the house, or like little footies or anything like that. But also, one trick that I kind of have always done and never really realized it, I was always sort of a cold person in school. It was always too cold for me, even if it was August. They would have the air conditioning up so strong that I would have to wear a sweater in August to school, right? So I've always done this, is to use drinks to either cool you down or warm you back up, because it really works throughout your whole body. If you drink a hot tea or hot coffee, or you know, whatever your preferred beverage, if you're cold, you're going to warm up. Same thing, you know, normally we drink like room temperature tap water, but recently I've kind of been making some tea and icing it down, or using, you know, doing ice water to and drinking that, and that really helps, you know, cool you down. It actually works. So doing that in addition to the clothing and controlling the thermostat, also getting fans going. Investing in a cheap fan that is small and can be right on you can save you tons of money if you in the warmer months. So for water, shower time is our number one like thing. We can spend a long time in the shower, and you know, you kind of get caught up in shower thoughts and, you know, but definitely kind of being conscious of, hey, let me go ahead and turn off the water and get out of here and, you know, think about all this stuff while I'm drying my hair or something like that, right? And for gas, We have natural gas. A lot of people have propane. I don't really know one for this, so leave me a comment if you do have a tip on saving on your natural gas or propane bill. I would like to hear about that. As for gas for your cars, definitely making one trip for everything. So if I go grocery shopping, a lot of times you guys see it in my grocery hauls, I'll go to 4 different stores, but I hit them all up in one day and I make sure I find the best route before I leave the house. So that's definitely one big way that we save on money is to, you know, make sure we're not leaving the house if we don't need to. Now, if we go out and go driving, or if we go out and go to a different town for our entertainment for the day, just to get out of the house, we definitely don't restrict ourselves there. We really like to explore. We're sort of in a new town. I think it's been like 4 months or something. I don't know, since we moved, but we love to find new areas. So, you know, for things that require us to go out, we'll definitely hit up a couple different places while we're out. Okay, number 3, what is your best tip to save on food and household products? So I have a whole video on how we save money on groceries. I am definitely an expert at it at this point, I can say. I will link that video in the description box for you under this question. But also, when we're, you know, using those steps for saving money on groceries, we also do a lot of combination deals. So I use Ibotta, Shopkick, coupons.com, as well as some other, you know, just Googling coupons, and then Walmart Savings Catcher app. So those 4 things you can often combine. So if you have a manufacturer coupon, plus you submit your receipt on Ibotta and Shopkick, and Walmart Savings Catcher, then you can definitely save some money on the name brand things that you buy, and a few generics as well, or just kind of like random items. Also buying generic. So most of the time we'll go the generic route versus a name brand, but if it's really close in price, or if I can find a coupon for it or a rebate for it, I'll go name brand if I like that, you know, flavor or whatever better, if it's a food item. Also buying multi-purpose tools. So stuff for like cleaning. So we don't have like 20 different cleaning products. If you guys would like to see the kind of cleaning products that we have, you want to see a video about that, let me know. Because I've kind of been thinking about doing a video about that, because we use like really multi-purpose items that like we have one cleaner for the whole house, and then we have a toilet bowl cleaner, and then we have dish soap, and you know, we don't have a whole lot else. Like there's not a lot of junk under our kitchen cabinets, like under our kitchen sink, filling that up. So definitely multi-purpose items to clean different parts of the house. It can be a good thing, you know, not just buying like scrubbing bubbles for the bathtub, and then you buy Lysol for the sink, and then you buy, you know, a countertop cleaner, and then you also buy a toilet bowl cleaner, and then you have one for your stainless steel. Like, it's stainless steel. It doesn't need a special cleaner, right? So that's another big one, the multi-purpose ones. Number 4, what is your best tip to save on clothing? It's always been buy quality, not quantity. There are so many fast fashion places out there that, you know, just sell really cheap clothes and they have really good deals, but you're going to be replacing them if you like wear like a uniform to work and you wear a specific type of undershirt. That's a big one for me. I wear undershirts under all of my shirts pretty much always, like any shirt that I wear, because women's clothing is like always see-through, right? I always wear an undershirt. So those undershirts, you know, if you're buying them every 6 months, it can really add up. So finding a quality one and sticking with it is definitely the way to go. Second thing, pick the item you want and watch for it to go on sale, and then combine it with a coupon or like a rebate app, like Ibotta or something like that. So for me, I've really been wanting, you know, I made a whole list. I said, okay, these are the socks that I want, and this is the brand that I want. These are the underwear. These are the undershirts. These are the uniform tops that I want to buy. And I really watch them like a hawk. And I sign up for emails from the places that each of those are from. And I kind of check them out pretty much weekly. We don't have a clothing budget right now, so when we do buy clothing, we just pull that from our miscellaneous, not really our miscellaneous fund, but currently it's the wedding fund. when it's, when we don't, you know, when we're not planning a wedding, it comes from whatever fund that is our biggest, or sometimes it will just, you know, budget it into the budget. But I always kind of have in the back of my mind, okay, these are the pieces that we need next, and this is where we want to get them from. So I just keep watching for a deal. But definitely, you know, waiting, not just immediately buying. That's kind of goes with anything though, is just that delayed gratification. Okay, number five, what's your best strategy to stay out of debt or pay it down? Number one's got to be a budget. If you don't have a budget, what are you doing here? Go watch my budget videos. my budget videos aren't just showing you my budget. I show you how I do my budget and my process. And I know that's something that not a lot of people do. And they can be long. They can be very long. They're like 40 minutes long. But, you know, I take you through my whole process if you're brand new, as well as, you know, if you just want to sit on the couch and munch on something and play a game on your phone and listen to me talk, you can do that too. So, because I enjoy doing that with other YouTubers. So, second part of this question that I have written down here is going back to number one, watching budgeting videos and watching Dave Ramsey. Number six. One thing I do to save money that other people don't know. So I wasn't really sure how to answer this because, you know, I've been making videos for like 2 years now. And it's kind of like, well, does this question mean that other people don't know that I'm doing or that other people don't know in general? So this is my answer. If I'm working, I can't be spending money. I pretty much agonize over like every decision other than eating out. I agonize over like every other purchase. If it's not food related, I'm like, do I need this planner? Is it going on sale for a better deal? Do I need this belt? I told you guys, Tyler and I have not gotten him a belt in like 3 months. And I talked about it on my budget video, and it's halfway through the month and he still doesn't have one. So we, like, how crazy is that? We're doing really well on not spending money on eating out, but then we still can't, you know, we agonize over that decision to buy clothing or, you know, whatever it is. It's just, we really, really think about it and say, do I really want to spend my money on this? It's a little bit easier for Tyler than it is for me, but, if I'm working, I can't just like on my break, go to Amazon and buy something. No, I have had to have it in my wish list or, whatever the other list is on Amazon, like your wish list or your shopping cart. I have to like have it in the shopping cart for like 3 days. If I'm going to buy anything from online. And okay. So the other night, I have to tell you this funny story. We were going to buy, some undershirts from Old Navy. That's where I get my undershirts. And I think Tyler wanted another pair of work pants because we've lost a lot of weight on this diet and like nothing fits us anymore. So like all of our pants are super baggy and like I don't have a single pair of shorts that fit. So the sale ended at midnight and it was a really good sale and we could combine it with a coupon that we had gotten. So I was like, okay, well now's the time to stock up, right? It took me an hour and a half to add 4 things to the cart. 3 of them were the same undershirt in the same color. Guys, it took me an hour and a half to buy those. Like, what is that? Okay, so that's my funny story about like how I agonize over spending money. And like, I didn't leave the website. I didn't like stop and go do something else. Like, I was like, are you sure? Do you think we should buy them now? Like, do you think it's going to be a better deal with that coupon that we have that's valid in September? And Tyler would have bought them like an hour and 10 minutes before or an hour and 20 minutes before instead of taking an hour and a half to do it. So that's why I do most of the spending for us. Okay, so if I'm working, I cannot be spending money. So number 7, how important is it for you to save money? Well, I think we just covered that one. So it's very important for us to save money on pretty much everything. So if we are going out to eat, we try to find a coupon for it. But anything else, like we really try to buy all clothing, all accessories, all cleaning products on some sort of sale or deal or something like that. And it's just, at this point, it's ingrained in us to, I can't buy that unless it's a deal. So I think we really need to get that way with eating out a little bit more. Now, I've really honed in on the grocery shopping, but with eating out, it's like, I can't go here unless it's like under $5 or under $10 or something. I think that needs to be our mindset. So, all right, guys, what do you think? Let me know your answers to these questions down in the comment box, as well as let me know if you've done this video. The description box is going to be a mile long, so definitely check it out. Hit the little arrow and definitely subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you, Marianne, over at Shopping Crafty for tagging me. And if you have any other tag videos, feel free to tag me. Anybody else? So, all right, guys, have a great day. I will see you in the next one. Bye.